President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. signed into law on Thursday a measure that classifies smuggling, hoarding, and cartel operations involving agricultural products as economic sabotage. Republic Act No. 1, 2022, or the Anti-Agricultural Economic Sabotage, aims to protect local agri workers and the economy by imposing stiffer penalties against smugglers and hoarders of agri-food products. For more on this, we have with us Ernesto Ordonez, Chairman of Alianza Agricultura and National Coordinator of Agri-Fisheries Alliance. Sir Ernie, good morning. Thank you so much for making the way to our studio this morning.
It's a pleasure to come here, especially the farmers who now have a voice. So thank you for this opportunity.
All right. Firstly, to classify agri-smuggling, hoarding, cartel under economic sabotage, that is the main point. That means stiffer penalties, life imprisonment, fines of up to 5 times the value of the goods involved. Are there other industries or other activities that have been classified under economic sabotage as we speak?
Well, as far as I know, those are the main ones for agriculture.
Mm-hmm. In other industries?
Well, other industries, they have the same kind of direction. That is to say, what will destroy the economy mm-hmm. will be economic sabotage. However, for economic sabotage, they must be at a certain high level. Mm-hmm. If not that, it's just called corruption, not economic sabotage. It has to have a certain level. What's good about this bill is they've gotten this economic sabotage in a way that it's low enough so that anything above that will be classified as economic sabotage. And you're right in what you said. The penalties are so light, now the penalties are life imprisonment. And what's best about this bill, what's best about it, is not only do you have life imprisonment and 5 times the value of the goods, is those who aid, those who transport, those who aid in this the same way Alice Guo was aided. Before, those who aided were not penalized. Now they're penalized. Very stiff, 20 to 30 years imprisonment. And that is very important. Mm. However,
I'm waiting for that.
Yeah.
What's the catch here? What do you think needs to be improved? What's needed?
Well, there are councils and councils and councils. And you find that they're not so fast. And sometimes they don't have the clout to handle things. This one has clout. However, they've got to do something which was proven already successful twice. And those 2 times, this group, which can be the executive committee of the council, council is 15 people, you know, it needs a smaller group that really acts. And this group should do what the 2 groups did before, but they were abolished because they were successful. And they were called the anti-smuggling committee, public, private. And believe it or not, they decreased smuggling by 27%, and they decreased smuggling the second time they were created by 31%. Both cases, they caught big fish, they were abolished. Now, what we want to do is have that council form a group, call it an executive committee, that will do exactly what they did. Now, what did they do that may not be done with this council? What they must do is have this group to meet the Bureau of Customs every month. That's what this committee did, okay? And meeting every month, they are forced to actually report to the president what happens. Because what happens is you have a council resolution, they take time, when does it come? And you know, if they, the key here, Mimi, the key here is to make sure Customs does what's needed. That's not happening because right now, when they talk to Customs may ignore them, unless they have a formal committee that we had before, we're reporting to the president, which now should be with the council. Now they will really attend to things. Mm-hmm. Not only will they handle complaints, more importantly, they will actually follow recommendations on systems. Several times we give to Customs systems that are obviously correct. They're just ignored because there's no clout. But before in this committee, when they give system, Mimi, they have to conform because they know that there are 4 departments watching and the private sector is there to make sure that interdepartmental courtesy, sometimes they don't want to talk to another department, you know, it may be polite. The private sector, in a sense, does it for them. So it's really amazing to cut smuggling by 27% and 31% is a fantastic feat. Mm. I'll tell you how bad it is. You're talking of the smuggling amount, okay, as measured by United Nations. In 2019, there was 500 billion, Mimi. 500 billion.
Mm-hmm. Total, not just agri.
Yeah. You know, in 2 years, it more than doubled to 1.2 trillion. And what has happened? Nobody is caught, as Senator Villar said in her speech. There's a law, no one has been convicted. It's ridiculous, right? So now I have this new law, which is fantastic. But if you don't have that small committee that meets customs every month, then you'll have resolutions, it will fine and all that. But you know, you will scare people the penalties. But first you gotta catch them. How do you catch them? You gotta catch them by these four departments and two private sector people talking to them, because they know the smugglers more than customs, maybe. Or maybe when customs knows them, there's some kind of evil collaboration. And right now, when that happens, where do we go? You go to them, they ignore you. I mean, where do you go? But with this clout, reporting to the president, where they know they can be fired or rewarded if they're a good job, something will happen. Mm.
Of course, Sir Ernie, you talk about this committee, that this group that used to be there twice, that brought smuggling down by 27 and 31. For those who are watching, you were part of that committee. You know.
Yes, I'm the only one who was in both committees and were second one when we got 31% reduction as the vice chair. And the important thing there, it's not just a regular group, it's an actual committee reporting to the president. So it says clout. So we appreciate the customs efforts right now, but sometimes they need us to help them. Sometimes the customs people are pressured by big politicians, etc. And what can
so
they
who
do?
Should be in this group again?
Okay.
So the private same, sector.
Yeah, the same group, not 15, no?
Okay.
But the same key ones that did it before. Who are they? Agriculture and trade and industry, obviously, right? Because they think in
from the departments.
Yeah, from the departments. Okay.
The secretaries, you mean?
Yeah. Well, they send some people, but at least they're already authorized, right? Then, of course, you need finance, which looks at customs, and you need cloud justice, and depart local government, right? Okay, that's what you need. And then for this one, have two from agriculture. Not 15. Mm-hmm. and with this group coming, customs will be ready. And that's every month, you see. Mm-hmm. It's not every 4 months. And every month, they'll be tasked to do certain things. Mm-hmm. And they have to follow the they have to follow recommendations if they're sensible. They cannot ignore them. Because now if they ignore them, who knows that they're ignoring them? There's a very good recommendation of Federation Free Farmers on how to do something, which is obviously correct, and they won't do it. So what can we do? But with this cloud, and of course you need the private sector. Without the private sector to help, first of all, they won't have as much information. And secondly, the private sector will be the motivator for the interdepartmental courtesy to give way to what's right for the country.
Sir Ernie, there are estimates that last year, for example, agricultural smuggling was valued at 3 billion pesos. Does that number sound about right to you?
No, it's much bigger than that. I would say it's more than double.
And this is mostly?
Well, you know rice. There's a lot of smuggling in rice, right? And of course, you have the standard fruits, vegetables, onions, etc., etc. But the smuggling is all over the place. And it's all over the place because they're not being caught, they're not being penalized. So this bill is important because it increases the penalties. But you know what they say? Fine, but you don't catch us anyway, so let's continue smuggling. That's why we need this little committee to move it. There are councils and councils. I used to be in government as an undersecretary and a secretary. There are so many councils I was part of, and they're excellent, but they don't have the speed and the action that's needed. This is terrible, smuggling is terrible. In fact, as you may know, when they were doing the regional comprehensive economic partnership, thanks to Senator Regarda, she said she would not be a chair unless they agreed on conditionalities that we, Agri-First Alliance, submitted. One of them is smuggling. Right. I talked to her yesterday, I was with her, I said, thank you, because of your conditionality, they're moving fast on this. And I talked to Congressman Enverga, the Agriculture Committee Chair, and he likes this idea of this committee that it will move every single month.
All right. We don't have time, sir, but thank you so much for the insights. You were there in Malacañang yesterday. You were watching on as the president signed that bill into law. Have you had a word? Have you had a chance to have a word with the president to relay this to him?
Well, I said hello to him yesterday, but he knows we're very involved in this. In fact, he's very interested in the success of this, and I support him fully on that.
All right. We can always count on you, sir, as a smuggling buster, our advocate in the agri. Thank you so much for joining us, Sir Ernie, really, and for the work that you do.
On behalf of the farmers, fisherfolk, thank you for giving us this voice. Thank you, Mimi.
All right.